Coin Toss presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Both teams have sent their special teams onto the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. The Wildcats' offense basically predicated on what this kid can do.
The thing I love about this guy, Brad, is just the intangibles that he brings to the table. We've been seeing this guy make plays over the weeks, but the thing that I really recognize is his ability to really lead this football team. When things are going well, he's patting everybody on the back. When things are not going well, he's trying to pick them back up and getting them ready to go. So not only does he physically have the tools, but also I really love the way he approaches the game.
From their own 23-yard line, second down. There.
That's a good completion. They didn't get the first down, but they picked up about 7 yards.
That'll make it 35.
Slings it to his fullback. Nowhere to go on that play action pass completion. Scott is the punter. And this one is a beauty. Stover fields it at the 22, brought down at the 30-yard line. So he managed to get a few yards on the run back.
Yeah, but I'll tell you, Brad, with so much traffic in the middle there, it really makes it tough to break free.
Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. He's to the 40, and he's taken down at the 49.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
From their own 49-yard line, first down. He's at the 40, makes it to the 34.
Anytime this guy carries the ball and gets a little space, we could be talking about six.
Feeds it to the back, and they get nice yardage on that run. It's second and six. Ball on the 30. Here's the pitch, and there's nobody near it. They'll bring him down at the 15. First and 10, ball on the 15-yard line. Brought down at the 12.
That's good for 3 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
Taken down at the 12-yard line. From the 12-yard line, third down. Quick throw, caught by the fullback. He's tackled at the 2.
Fullbacks do a lot of dirty work throughout a game, so it's nice to call their number once in a while and let them make something happen. He made a nice catch there for a solid game.
Here's the 8th play of the series. They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. And they make the stop just outside the goal line. That's a deep one.
second and goal.
It's second and goal. Ball on the one. And they're in. Touchdown. And he hits the PAT. A nine-play, 69-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running back.
The score now, 7-0. Wheeler ready to kick. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. The Mustangs are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. He takes it right side for a good game. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Gets to about the 34-yard line. And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five receiver look. At the 37.
That'll bring up fourth and one.
Room around the corner. And down he goes at the 32-yard line. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Runs outside for a nice gain.
That brings him second and five.
Second and five. Ball on the 37-yard line. Pushed out of bounds at the 48-yard line.
Even if you're pulling for the other team, you've got to just admire this guy's speed. He is special.
Runs it and tackled in the backfield. We're through one quarter. The Mustangs with a touchdown lead. And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. Fakes it, and the quarterback scrambles. Slides down. He scrambled and picked up a couple of yards.
That brings up third and 10.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 42. Couldn't pick up the long yardage, and now they'll have to punt.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
Dixon to punt. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Gets out to about the 22-yard line. From their own 22-yard line. Second down.
carries the ball for a nice gain.
That's a gain of 7 on the play. That'll make it 3rd and 1.
Gets out to around the 38.
The play was very well conceived as they were able to get a decent gain and a first down.
From their own 38-yard line. First down. Makes it out to about the 49.
The 37-yard line.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
From the 37-yard line, it's first down. Mistake will cost this offense possession of the ball.
And this young safety was right there to pick up the fumble. Huge break for the defense.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Up the middle for a nice game. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back.
Personal foul. Clipping. Offense.
That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
It's first down and a lot. Intercepted there.
How did he drop that? The defender did everything that he needs to do. He read the play perfectly. He stepped up, and what does he do? Drops the interception. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Tackle made right around the 20. From their own 20-yard line, it's third down. There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. He airs it out. Oh, boy, almost intercepted. We've got a change at the quarterback position. Got to wonder how that's going to affect this offense. I would think the offensive coordinator and the head coach are just going to try to ease him into this game at the beginning. Green awaiting the return. Signals for a fair catch. Wildcats have really got some work to do, I think, Kirk, in the second half, because from what we've seen from their quarterback so far, if he's their star, it's not shining right now, and they got to find somebody else to light up the sky a little bit.
Well, I think collectively as a head coach, an offensive coordinator, quarterback coach, they're all going to have to get together and take some time to visit with this quarterback at halftime and try to find out if they can somehow get him going. And the other thing to think about is maybe this is where the running backs, maybe it's this is their week to take some of the pressure off of. Maybe the receivers, the offensive line, when your star isn't playing up to his abilities, he has a tendency to press. Somebody else has to step up their game and take some of the pressure off.
The Wildcats will use their first time out of the half. From midfield, it's second down. And the fullback plows ahead for maybe a yard.
And that was the freshman linebacker who was right there to make the play.
Flushed out, and he's going to get sacked.
Quick throw out to the receiver. And down he goes, right around the 46-yard line. This punt, if he gets it where he wants, it can really change the field position in this football game. They snap into the up back, and he's tackled at the 47. Unable to pick up the first down, and the ball will change hands. Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He's got it with room to run. And he's tackled around the 37-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 37.
Here we go. Green 90. Green 90.
Makes the catch and look out. And he's taken down the 27-yard line. The Mustangs call a timeout. That's their second of the half. He's got room. And they push him out around the 10-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
Looking to go up two touchdowns. Complete. He's got room to work. Knocked out of bounds at the one.
That's a deep 10. That brings him second and goal.
And he's in the end zone. Touchdown. Once again, he finds the end zone. That's his second rushing touchdown of the game.
He's run the ball very well, and he's going to see a lot more carries before this one's over. He's really helped carry the offense so far today.
And he converts the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's got the corner. He's out to the 30. He's knocked out of bounds at the 34.
No matter how much people want to talk about points and offense, I still think that the best offense is a great defense. When you put a zero up there, it makes it pretty easy on your own offense to go out there and win the game.
We're about set to start things. Fires in a hurry. Interception. He's at the 40. They'll bring him down at the 34-yard line.
Brad, it's still early in this game, and they might be able to get back into it. I just feel like the quarterback seems to be forcing things a bit. I understand trying to get back and fighting to get back in the game, but that time to throw an interception when you really need points, that was a big mistake.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 34-yard line.
Here we go.
Setting up blockers, a running back's got it on the screen. Steps out of bounds at the 31.
That'll make it second and seven.
He scrambles. Brought down around the 27-yard line. He's scrambling, runs with it, and he's got room. He's taken down at the 12. Well, we've played a half of football. The Mustangs lead it by 2 touchdowns. Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 27. It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? Gives it left side. He's gobbled up in the backfield.
I think calling the plays, you've got to be aware of this guy. He's making too many plays. And when he's that close to the line of scrimmage, defending the run, not allowing your running back to even get up to the line of scrimmage, you've got to do something to make him pay for that. If he's going to cheat up to the line of scrimmage, if you're calling the plays, listen up. This is a great time to go play action and try to throw the ball right over top of his head.
The ball is loose. It's picked up. Third and long now after the sack.
Set the tone, defense. Set the tone, defense. Let's go. Hey, check my
three. Fires that quickly to the tailback. He's tackled around the 23-yard line.
That's good for the game, 7 yards. That'll make it 4th and 13.
Dixon is waiting for the snap. He really got a hold of that one. Green takes it at the 23. Tackle at the 29-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And they make the stop at the 37-yard line. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
Defense had that one called perfectly. That's a big play on that one.
Screen pass. Tackle at about the 39-yard line. From their own 39-yard line. First down. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line.
That makes it 2nd and 10.
He throws it. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice gain.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 40. Just gets rid of it. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
And he's immediately tackled.
That makes it 3rd and 3.
third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Tackled for a loss.
That is exactly the type of play that good linebackers make on a regular basis. And if you can make enough of them in college, you're probably going to get a chance to play at the next level.
Kicks up, and he nails the long field goal. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They are ready to begin another drive. Scrambling around. Tackle made at the 32. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Pitches it. He's got the corner. He's at midfield. And he's finally shoved out at the 42. The 42-yard line. First down. He gets to about the 34-yard line.
That'll be 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
He makes it to the 32-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line. He fights forward to about the 30.
That makes it second and 8.
Quickly to the tight end. He'll take it all the way for the touchdown. And he adds the extra point. To kick this one away. He sends this one deep. And they can forget about returning this one. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And down he goes at the 35-yard line.
That's good for him.
From their own 35-yard line, it's first down. Gets to about the 37-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That brings up second and 9.
So at the end of three, the Mustangs lead 21-3. back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He's at midfield. He's at the 40. Inside the 30. And he's tackled at the 26-yard line.
Holmes makes the tackle at the 26-yard line. First down.
So the big gain resulting from the pass play leaves us with a first and 10. He's pushed out of bounds at the 19-yard line.
Gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and 3.
They'll knock him down for a loss.
He just timed the snap count there. It really made a nice play.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 15.
Boy, the defense has to be very frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack. Somehow, he's able to throw the ball away.
Now we'll see how the backup can do after that injury. Quick strike to the receivers, and he's taken down at the 14-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. To him before he could get back to the line.
Man, did he play that perfectly or what? As a linebacker, you have to be able to read the offense and make a quick diagnosis, which is exactly what he did on that play.
So it's second and 13, ball on the 17-yard line. And they get nice yardage on that run. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Setting up play action. He gets sacked on the play. And again, they're going for it on fourth down.
Key 15.
Quick throw to the back, it's incomplete. And they're going to have to give the ball back after going for it on fourth and long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
You aren't going to convert many fourth downs against this defense. That's a really good stop. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Nice run there. Pearson comes away with 5 yards on the carry. From their own 22-yard line. Second down. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. His way to the 30-yard line. Nice run, and he's brought down. A 5-yard pickup by the halfback on the misdirection.
That brings him second and 5.
We've got a second and 5. Ball on the 35. Makes it out to about the 43.
Double
takes it out to about the 44-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That makes it second and eight.
And this one comes to an end. Our final count in this game, 21-3, Mustang. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.